गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग। हाँ, सो दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन क्लास ऑफ द डिस्कशन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एम एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स एट एलिमेंट्री एंड सेकेंडरी लेवल। सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन द एम एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स एट एलिमेंट्री लेवल। इन दिस सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट आर द एम एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स एट सेकेंडरी लेवल। एंड इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल सी the learning outcome at elementary and secondary level of learning mathematics. So that we will discuss in the next class, but in the today we will see what are the aim and objective of teaching mathematics at secondary level. I think in the previous class we were not had sufficient time for question answer session, and I have told you that we will start the class with the question answer session. So is there any question from the previous class or classes? Is there any question? No question. Asis, do you have any question from the previous class?
No, sir.
Okay. So I think now we can start the further discussion. So till now we have seen that the objective of teaching mathematics at an elementary level is to motivate them to learn mathematics, to bring their attention, interest in learning mathematics. And that's why we have the objective and aim related to the real life, means whatever the mathematics or whatever the work we do in our day-to-day life that have some implication of the mathematics. And here we have also seen that the methods of teaching mathematics is the playway method, or with the examples, or with the variety of the opportunity where they can observe that how mathematics is being used in doing the day-to-day work. And one of the major emphasis in teaching mathematics at elementary level is the inductive method. That is, the from the exemplification we are coming to a generalized conclusion and the formula, so that the children can see and observe how the mathematical concepts are being derived out of the things that we are doing in our day-to-day life, out of the things which we used to observe from our day-to-day life. So in a nutshell, we can say that the major emphasis of teaching mathematics at elementary level is to capture their attention, to motivate them in learning mathematics. And why it is very much necessary? Because in the society where we used to live, there is a wrong notion has been propagated that mathematics is a very tough subject, it is a very hard to understand, and that's why the student demotivated from learning mathematics right well before the starting learning mathematics. Whereas when we talk about the aim and objective of learning mathematics at a secondary level is again to motivate them to learn mathematics in higher classes. But here we start linking the mathematical concept with the vocations, means whatever, what kind of a profession, vocation they will have in future for their livelihood. Also, we introduce some of the mathematics that have a implication in the other fields like science, like bioscience, like social science, like that. So that we also try to link. And another thing what we here used to do is that we introduce how we can use the mathematical principle in order to solve our day-to-day life problem, real life problem, means the problem that we are facing in our day-to-day life. So we start linking all those things with the mathematics that we used to learn in a secondary level. So now all those things we will see one by one. The one of the major objective of teaching mathematics, just now I was telling, that to develop the people's ability of solving real life problem, that are the problem that we are facing in our day to day life, irrespective of whatever the vocation that we used to do. Like that, even though we are doing a carpentry, even though we are doing agriculture work, or even though we are going to purchase a vegetable in the market. I remember my own childhood time, my father used to take us, means me, my brother and my sister, when he was going for the marketing. And when suppose that one vegetable is of 25 rupees per kg, then he purchased 25 grams, suppose that, or a half kg. So well before the shopkeeper or the vegetable vendor will say that how much money it will cost, my father used to ask that, tell me how much money I should give. And when I was giving the money, so he was telling that how much money he will return. So that is the real life implication of the simple mathematical operations that we have learnt at an elementary level. It is also the application of the exchange value, the measurement, linking measurement with the money, like that. So this is the one of the very simplest example of application of mathematics in our day to day life. But here at a secondary level, we emphasize on the using the mathematical principle for solving other work. Suppose that we have to make some sort of a construction. So estimating the cost of construction by considering the cost of different component that will be used in constructing that thing. Even at a secondary level, we expect that beyond that, the child will be able to use the principle that they have learnt in mathematics in solving day-to-day life problem, like that the approach of a scientific approach, precision in their work, pinpoint to the point while the children is presenting something, accuracy in doing the work, problem solving ability when the child will encountered any sort of a problem. And we know that the secondary education is a stage in the life of a child when they are at an adolescent age. And the adolescent age, as per the developmental perspective, when we see, it is the stage when the child encounters a lot of problem due to the biological change, due to the emotional change, and so on. So, how the child will overcome? So, that is supposed to be empowered by learning mathematics at that stage. So, solving a real life problem doesn't mean that you will go to the for the marketing and you will learn how to do the exchange. That is the also important thing. But the ultimate goal is to solve the real life problem with the problem solving ability that has been developed by learning mathematics at a elementary and a secondary level. Okay, so now we will see the another objective of teaching mathematics, that is to develop logic, reasoning and thinking power in the people. As we know that every discipline has a distinct nature, and when we learn those discipline, we assume and it is required to acquire those things within the self and use those things for performing work. And that's why when we talk about the different commission, like the Secondary Education Commission, like a Kothari Commission, like that, even when we see the different policy framework of a program, like at a secondary level, that is a RAMSA, you will find that mathematics has been emphasized. When we see the RAMSA policy framework, you will find that the language, especially the English, mathematics and science, these three things is emphasized. I am not talking that the other subject doesn't have a value and those are not mentioned to be incorporated at a secondary level. But all the things together with all the things, mathematics, science and English has been emphasized. Why? Because through the science, we used to develop a scientific temper, which enables us to remove the ill practices in the society, superstition in the society, that are the very much required thing for development of the human civilization. And together with those, mathematics has been kept as a prominent place, because through the learning mathematics, we suppose that we know that we can develop a logical thinking, reasoning, creative thinking. And that's why it has been emphasized. And through learning mathematics at a secondary level, it is supposed that we will develop all those things among the learner, and the learner will be able to use those things for performing their day-to-day work. The next thing in this series is to prepare a child to lead a productive, creative and a constructive life. How to prepare a child for leading a productive, creative and a constructive life? Because through the learning mathematics, the child will develop the creative thinking, logical thinking and the problem solving ability, and that will empower them to perform the day-to-day work with optimum efficiency, and that will also empower them to do the different kind of work with the constructive approach, and in turn the constructive approach will result as a innovative practices. Because the innovative practices require the conceptualization of performing the work from the variety of way and analyzing which way will be more efficient, more useful in doing the work. So that's why it is visualized that. The next one is the developing problem solving and a conceptualization of the problem. Means the point of saying is that in order to solve the problem from the day-to-day life, first you have to realize, conceptualize the problem, that what kind of a problem you are facing. For example, I am saying you have thought of securing very good mark in the matric examination, that is a board examination of a 10 that the student have thought of. But in order to secure a very good position, very good mark in the board examination, they have to analyze, understand and conceptualize that what is required, where I am, what is required, and from where I am to what is required, what kind of a things needs to be done. Because you will be at a one position and you will try to achieve some other position, higher position. So what is required to achieve that position? Where is the lacuna? And when you will able to identify and conceptualize that where is the lacuna, then you can devise a plan to overcome those lacunas, to improve that situation. If you will fail, then it will be very difficult. And that's why we understand that through the learning mathematics, through the solving mathematical problem, the child will develop an approach. The child will develop an insight of identifying and solving problem. So that is required. And that's why when we see the NCF 2005, I think several times I have discussed, that's why the NCF 2005 talks about the higher aim and a lower aim. Narrow aim or a lower aim of learning mathematics is to learn the procedures of a computation, computational procedures, proficiency, whereas the higher aim is to mathematization of a thought process. The mathematization of a thought process plays a role here, because you have developed the computational ability, and with the help of a computational ability and with the help of whatever the problem you have identified and the approach you have adapted, you will able to execute that and you will able to solve the problem. And in the process of a solving a problem, your proficiency in doing a computational work will help here. And that's why another more important feature of the framework is the problem solving framework that is given by the George Polya, is to develop a reflective practices. The last stage, that is the looking back, it is the reflection. In fact, when we talk about the George Polya framework of problem solving, it has a inbuilt mechanism of a reflection. Because when we devise a plan, when we execute a plan, so all those things when we used to do, so we learn from that. Continuously we are learning, and that is helping us in solving the real problem. That attitude that we have learned, the approach that we have learned, it is not like that when we will solve the problem from the geometry or a trigonometry or a algebra, so that will help the solving real life problem. That indirect, that is not helping, but that is helping in terms whatever the attitude, whatever the approach of looking at a problem and solving, searching for a solution of a problem we are searching for. Okay, so that used to help. So before discussing the other thing in this series, I will like to have a short break for the question answer session. So anybody, if you have got any question, you can just ask me now, and after that we will proceed further. Any question from anybody? Kishore Chandramal ji, are you here? Kishore? Kishore Chandramal ji?
Yes, sir.
Are you here na?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay. And what about Subhasri? Are you here? Subhasri?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So you don't have any question? Okay. That was, means whatever we have discussed up to here, that was related to developing and enriching the ability in the child for the future, even for the living the life successfully, living the life with the you can say that with the skills to live, how to live the life. Now we will see the other aspect in terms that how the mathematics prepares a child for the better vocational opportunity. Because for the living a life, when we think of learning something, it should help from the multiple way. It should enrich to solve the problem, it should also provide a opportunity to earn the livelihood. And surprisingly, it is not only to you, but surprisingly, whenever I ask the B.Ed. student, those who are in the mathematics pedagogy till now, to whom I have taught, when I ask that why you have chosen to learn mathematics at a graduate level or a plus 2 level or even at a PG level, some of them reply that I wanted to learn science, and that's why I have studied mathematics, because mathematics used to help us. That's a fine. Sometime also reply that they have studied mathematics due to the family pressure. Okay, because they may not be interested very much, but due to the family pressure, they have thought of studying mathematics. But surprisingly, more surprising aspect of this discussion where that some of them told that even though I will not get a job in terms of the government job, everything whatever we used to do is a profession and the professionalism is required. So job, they were talking in terms of the government job. They told that I can opt for opening a coaching institute, I can opt for going for the tuition, and through that I can earn my livelihood. So it provides the better opportunity for earning, better earning opportunity it provides. Better earning means that you will get a better opportunity for the vocational opportunity. So, don't think that I am here trying to neglect the contribution of other subject or other discipline in shaping and nurturing the human. All are very much required, even the language, even the social science, even the science, humanities, all things are required. But in the opinion of a children, I am talking the children's opinion, they used to think that with the help of mathematics, they will be empowered to earn their livelihood in a better manner. And also very surprisingly, and I agree with that also, some of the used to tell that after plus 3, that is a graduation or a plus 2, when they will go for the competitive examination for a different competitive examination for admission, suppose that the MBA, okay, or different competitive examination for the recruitment like the SSC, like the railway examination and the other examination. They used to say that there is a necessary part of that is the mathematics and reasoning, and that can be developed by learning mathematics. Even though they have not systematically gone through the nature of mathematics, because when we go through the nature of mathematics, we understand that all those things can be inculcated very easily by learning mathematics, but they emphasize that by learning mathematics, I can do better in that. Better in that means the child will have a better opportunity for the livelihood. So, in top means in a nutshell, we can say that by the learning mathematics, the children can get a better vocational opportunity, enriched vocational opportunity. And that's why when we see the curriculum of a secondary school across the country, means for any board, we find that mathematics is placed as a compulsory subject up to class 10th. Means up to class 10th, you have to read the mathematics, because those things have been identified. And that's why one of the aim of learning mathematics at a secondary level is that to prepare the child for different vocations, to provide them a better vocational opportunity. Okay. The next one is to develop and appreciate towards the culture and the fine arts. How to develop the culture and the fine arts, can anybody say? How it helps in appreciating different culture and fine arts? Anybody? Ah, yes?
Yes, sir.
Ah, yes, please tell.
So actually it helps, when we draw something, we should know about the how to draw, and the for mathematicity, due to mathematicity, to major and draw.
Okay. Acha. Any other? Banaja Misra, can you tell something? Acha, Asis is interested to say something. Yes, Asis.
Sir, एक example के साथ बता सकता हूँ.
Yes, 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 sure.
सर साउथ में एक मंदिर है, उसका फोटो थोड़ी देर पहले वायरल हुआ था. उसका कंस्ट्रक्शन जो मॉडल था, वो जो सारे पिलर जाके एक पॉइंट पे मर्ज होते थे लास्ट में जाके. उस पॉइंट के लिए सारे इंजीनियर्स को, मतलब उसके जो टैलेंट है, ये सब जो मैथमेटिक्स के यूज करके वो सब ये कर पाए ना.
यस यस, बिकॉज इन ऑर्डर टू सर्वाइव एनी बिल्डिंग, बिकॉज टेम्पल इज अ बिल्डिंग.
यस.
So, in order to survive, or better to say the structure, in order to survive any structure, their center of gravity should be at the center of the structure, so that it will be balanced and it will survive. Even when we see the leaning building of the Pisa, so it is leaning, but its center of gravity is at a center point of the structure. Okay, if it is not at a center point, then it won't survive. Even though if it is surviving, then it won't survive in a very minor earthquake also. Okay, so in order to survive, yes, so in that way we have to balance the symmetry of the structure. Yes, anybody else? Ayushmati, are you here? Ayushmati Behra?
Yes, sir.
Would you like to say something?
Sir, jo 3D dimension mein
hai. 3D dimension hai, wo kya hota hai?
Math use hota hai.
Acha, math use hota hai. See, when we talk about the appreciating culture and art, better to say in the broad perspective, the art. We know that the mathematics is a science of pattern. Why it is used to science of a pattern? Because when we see the starting point of any mathematical branch or a concept, we find that it has been derived by observing a pattern, lots of a pattern, sufficient pattern, and by observing the pattern, it has been generalized. So that the generalization part we see, which is coming from the pattern. It has a definite pattern. Suppose that for sake of example, I am telling you, I will like to share one thing so you will understand it in a better manner. One minute. Okay, so are you able to see the whiteboard?
No, sir.
Okay. No. So, I was talking about the pattern, that is the principle of mathematics has been derived from observing a pattern. For sake of example, I am saying that is a suppose that this is 25 and this is 25. So how you will multiply that? You will multiply 5 to 5, it will be 25, and then we will keep 2, then it will be 5 to 10, and then 2, it will be 12, and then it will be 5 2 into 5, it will be 10, that is will be 0, 1 we will carry, and then 2 to 4 and 1 it is 5, and then here we will add these things, so it will come 5, it will come 2, it will come 6. So this is the multiplication. Again, we may think of multiplying 15 into 15, So how will multiply 5 5 are 25. So 5 we will write here, 2 we will keep, and 5 to 7, and then it will be 5 1 5 5, and then it will be 1 1 1. So the multiplication will be, here we will add, so 5 and then 7 5 12, 2 and 1 1 2, so it will be 2. So a number of multiplication has been done by this, because this is the method of doing multiplication. But by doing the multiplication with this procedure, we have observed one thing. And what was our observation? Our observation was that when we multiply, then the multiplied thing are in this format. See, in which format? 5 means the multiplication are in this format, means when we have to multiply with the same number whose unit is 5. See, here we are multiplying with the same number. 25 is multiplied by the 25, 15 is multiplied by the 15, and whose unit digit is 5. So unit is 5, unit is 5, unit is 5, unit is 5. So we have observed that 625 in a such a way that you multiply the 5 5, that is a 25, and increase any one number by 1, so it will be 3. So 3 2 ja 6. See, it has come to a correct result. You can do here also 5 5 25. You increase this 1, so it will become 2. So it will be 2 1 ja 2, 225. Like that you can multiply 75 also. 75 multiplied by 75. Unit is 5 and it is multiplication by itself, so it will be 5 5 25. You increase 1, so it will be 8, so it will be 7 8 ja 56. So multiplication will be like this. So we have done a lot of a series of multiplication, and we have come to a conclusion that the multiplied, means the product number, is in this format. And since it is in this format, so instead of doing a mechanical multiplication, direct we can approach to this number. Direct we can approach to this number. Directly we can come to this number. Okay. So this is the one of the beautiful example of multiplication, where we use the patterns. But this was the very simple example of a use of a pattern in the multiplication. But when we see the, suppose that vocal art, where we used to sing, so the notes, that is the musical notes, are in the different, means the particular pattern. And if it is in a particular pattern, then it will look musical. It will be soothing to the ears. If you will simply play the tabla, suppose that any musical instrument at random, it won't soothe your soul and the ear. It will be noise. But when you will play in a particular sequence, then it will be a music. You will draw a figure in a proper arrangement. You will arrange the things in a proper sequence, then it will be a art. Okay. And that's the application of mathematics even in those fields. इवन द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ अ मैथमेटिक्स इन द लिटरेचर. सपोज दैट व्हेन यू विल सी द पोएम्स और सपोज दैट द दोहा ऑल दोज थिंग्स और अ चौपाई, बेटर टू सी द वन ऑफ द एंशियंट पोएट्री ऑफ in the Indian culture, that is the Ramayana. When you will read those things, you will find that the words are in the proper sequence and it gives a very soothing meaning and a soothing feel when you recite that. However, when we talk about the modern poetry, those things are not very much available. So it has a meaning, but it has a less soothing effect than the old poetry. You just see and you will find it. So that's the application of mathematics there. Then the other thing is that to develop the power of expression in the people, because mathematics has a different kind of a language which is very much accurate and precise. And when you will go for talking with anybody, authority, if you will say, express your whatever it is in a very to the point, precise way, accurate way, and if you will say in a very a story kind of a way, which one will be more effective? When it will be precise. I have seen that so many people used to write a letter. They used to write like a story. And in the this busy world, no one have a time to read your stories. So it gives a power of expressing yourself. Okay. Then we have already seen that to prepare, it has another objective to prepare them for elementary as well as the higher education in science, economics, engineering and other things, even for language and literature, even for the social science, humanities, everything. Because the wide application of mathematics in the other discipline, and some of the discipline like biotechnology, biophysics, even the medical, which requires the proficiency in mathematics as well. So that is also very much required, and that's why the other objective of teaching mathematics at a secondary level is to empower them for learning those kind of things. Then to develop the habit of a concentration, self-reliance and a discovery, because it develops a sense of creativity, doing a work differently, having a multiple approach to solve a problem, which in turn promotes the innovative ideas, discovery, that kind of a thing. Then in this series I will discuss that to bring about all round development, harmonious development and the all round development of the personality of the child. Just think that if the child have a better way to express, better way to communicate, have a innovative idea, ability to solve a problem, like that. So obviously the child will be more successful. The child will be able to adjust in the different situation. They will have a harmonious relation with the other stakeholders in their life. In turn, it will enable the child to have a more successful life. Okay, so this was the some of the objective of teaching mathematics at a secondary level. By this we will stop this discussion, and in the next class we will see the some of the learning objective that is framed by the NCERT. learning objective, both we will see that in half an hour we will see the learning objective at a elementary level, and half an hour we will see the learning objective at a secondary level. So now we will have a question answer session. So anybody who have a question from the today's discussion, now may ask. Anybody? Do you have any question? Vibhu, do you have a question? Rosaline and Amiranj, acha, so no questions, sir. Okay, so I think then if there is a no question, so we can stop the session here. Shall we stop the session?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, thank you for being with me in this session. Have a nice day.